is the Rolls-Royce, still the Shadow 1979 model that was the last of the series. Started off in 1965, ran for over 15 years. The last of the model had a few changes, something like 2,000 odd changes since it was first introduced in 1965. The main change was it had rack and pinion steering. The Silver Shadow was the most prolifically produced Rolls-Royce in history and still is. There was 32,000 of them built. A lot of people say, oh, it's not really a Rolls-Royce because it's got an American gearbox, an American radiator, American power steering, it's got American ignition, and a Delco air conditioning system, which is also American. When Rolls-Royce was first built, it was the two builders. There was Henry Royce and Mr. Rolls. Rolls was the first man to die in an aircraft accident in Britain, and it was left to Royce, the engineer, to take over and run the business. And as I said, he was an engineer, but he once said that he's not an inventor. He takes engines and gearboxes and what have you from other manufacturers and then improves on them. And the same is the case with this Rolls-Royce, having the best of other manufacturers involved in its construction. Other than that, as I say to people, the only reason I bought a Silver Shadow Rolls-Royce is because I couldn't afford a Holden Torana. And this would be the cheapest classic car you could buy on the market today, is a Rolls-Royce of any model. Other than that, I enjoy it. Thanks, John.